It's alright. By all means, I should have been rather disinterested in this project, but there was just something about Irish singer-songwriter, musician, and producer Eden that has consistently brought me back to listen to his projects. I do genuinely enjoy his indie-tronica music, with a little bit of an acoustic flavour to it, but also some bits of glitch in there. It's not, like, experimental stuff, but there's, like, interesting things going on with the sound design and the way that he plays with emotionally potent moods. However, I have felt as if up until this point, Eden still had room to play around with how he presented a story, maybe perhaps doing it in a more musically dynamic and interesting way, or perhaps telling a new story that wasn't too reliant on your typical generic relationship troubles. And my word, does he pull it off on Vertigo. First off, I have to mention that sound design on this album. Ugh. Mind you, there are some moments such as in the middle stretch of the album that seem to become a little bit homogenous or perhaps a bit too sparse, but to this album's advantage, there is not a single moment on this album that doesn't sound at least melodically pleasing or absolutely gorgeous from a songwriting perspective, or especially a lyrical perspective too. The album starts off with a solo vocal that is harmonized upon itself, very much reminiscent of Imogen Heap, or if you want more modern examples that have taken after Imogen Heap, then maybe like James Blake or Bon Iver. However, Eden doing this is like a perfect, intimate opening to the album, which then goes straight into the track Take Care. Now, what attracted me to this track was the faint machine-like hum, the distant clicking. There's clearly something different going on than your usual acoustic folk pop track. And as the track and the album in general progresses, we very much feel like Eden has just propelled us into the sky and we're just drifting and floating in a blue abyss. On the track Lost and Found, the bare acoustic guitar makes him sound isolated, as if he's locked in his bedroom, which is like a massive contrast to the previous track, which was so much more spacier and colossal and moving. This album totally gets mood right. The glitches on the vocals on Start, End, and Crash, they sound so volatile and potent to spiral out of control. Eden sounds like he's nonchalantly singing his grievances, but there's so much happening to his voice and the production that makes it sound as if he is just merely trying to hold himself together. The big issues with this album, if any really, they're very kind of faint for me personally, but maybe there are some moments where I think the album just loses a little bit of momentum. It doesn't quite have the same impact as tracks like Take Care all the way through to Icarus. However, I still love the little subtle details in the music, like the bright, sunny drone that builds towards the end of Wonder. I only wish this drone fully manifested and had a chance to pierce the end of the song, if you will, and instead of kind of fades out, I wish it finished that crescendo at the very end. However, the stunner towards the very end of the album was the track Love Not Wrong, Brave, where the sampled crowd cheers are utterly gorgeous touches to the boldest cut from the album. These crowd cheers are like brief flashbacks to past memories. They feel that way. They're like a sudden burst of motivation from the past before you get these aggressive hits of guitar, making up one of the most defined bursts of confidence and one of the awe-inspiringly uplifting moments that we have been waiting for on the album since track one. And then the final track, Falling in Reverse, features these glass shatters, and hearing them at the end just makes just the final impact of the album so much more powerful. It's like the sonic equivalent of breaking down walls, and all of this is backed by heart-wrenching violins and these reversed drones, these backmasked drones that they sound like they're just drifting elegantly in the background, soon leading into the final notes of piano, which conclude the record on a very intimate and gentle note. Conceptually, this thing isn't necessarily anything new. However, I don't think it necessarily needed to be in order to be a stunning moment for Eden. I think all he needed to do was really just take his sound design, take the way he presents these stories to the next level, and I think that's what he does with such creative songwriting and all the layering of different sounds to create different moods. I think there really is just something fantastic about this album. Definitely making more ambitious moves on this record. Not as much of a commercial effort as the stuff you might hear with like his collabs with G Nash and Black Bear. I'm gonna give this a very strong 7 out of 10. Yep. Yeah.